Well, back in 1962, I used to sing in this group called the New World Singers. We used to play in Gertie's Folk City, which was the kind of hot folk venue back then. They had these fabulous, what they called hoot nights. Monday nights were kind of open mic kind of nights. And you'd be amazed at the people you'd see there, from Joan Baez and Judy Collins, and Peter, Paul, and Mary would come by, or Bob Dylan would do a song, and it would be a huge scene of really amazing musicians. Phil Oakes, Tom Paxton, Dave Van Ronk, just on and on. And the New World Singers were booked several times for week or 2 week long gigs there. And the Late Show, very often, which would start around 1 a.m. or something, Bob Dylan would come in and sit in with us. He used to hang out there a lot and was really good friends with Mike Porco, who was the owner of the place. And so we got to playing and singing a lot with Bob back then when we were playing at Gertie's. And one day, Gil Turner, who was the lead singer in the New World Singers, came to me and said, "You've got to hear the song that Bob just taught me." And we went downstairs to the basement of Folk City, where the so-called dressing room was, which was kind of a rat hole in the basement of this place. It was not a place you want to spend a lot of time. And as I remember, Bob might have been there too, and Gil took out this piece of paper that Bob had given him, kind of a torn loose leaf or spiral-bound notebook paper with some words scrawled on it, and it was "Blowin' in the Wind," first time we ever heard that song. Gil had learned it from Bob, and then they together taught it to us, and the following week we had an arrangement of it and started playing it. And then in early 1963, we went into the studio to make a record to benefit Broadside Magazine, which was publishing lots of new up-and-coming songwriters like Phil Oakes and Eric Anderson and Bob Dylan and Tom Paxton, and all these people who were writing a lot of mostly political, topical songs, but also funny songs, all kinds of love songs. And so we did a benefit recording for them. It was the first time I was ever in a recording studio in a professional way, so I was very excited about it. It was the result of it was a record called Broadsides. It was the first of many volumes. I have an old beat-up copy of it here that I've been saving. This was the original Broadside. Folkways Records put it out. And on this record, Pete Seeger and Peter Lafarge, the New World Singers, which was our group, Mark Spolstra, and who else is on here? The Freedom Singers, a fabulous group from Albany, Georgia, very involved in the civil rights movement. And just being in a studio with Pete Seeger and Bob Dylan and all these other people was very exciting. That record has recently been released with a bunch of others on a CD box set called The Best of Broadsides that Smithsonian Folkways, who now owns Folkways Records, put out. So you might be interested in this. It's a multi-CD set, and it's got a lot of great songs in here and a lot of the topical, political, freedom-type songs from the 60s are on this. Anyway, when we were in the studio, I did a duet with Bob on a song called Let Me Die in My Footsteps, and the New World Singers did three songs as a group, and one of them was Blowin' in the Wind, the first time it had ever been recorded. It came out, and shortly thereafter, Peter, Paul, and Mary's version came out, and that was history.